here on the left-hand side, folks. At the top there, do you see the beige and white buildings? That is the All Saints Secondary School. Now, the All Saints Secondary School was once famous for producing many cricketers here on the island. Now, one such cricketer that attended the school was Mr. Curly Ambrose. He was a very tall fellow, tall like Randy Johnson. Now, could any of you English fellows tell me how many wickets did Curly Ambrose get?
Too many.
I need an exact number. Yes, Doug. Five? You're a bit close there. But he actually got 405. 405, folks. So if you want to see currently, just look for a live stream that says 405. Now, the school age in Antigua begins at 2.5 and ends at the age of 18. 2.5 is just pre-K age because we've got to start them off with their ABCs and 1-2-3s. While the school hours are from 8 to 1:30, private schools and also secondary schools, and from 9 to 3 p.m. for the government primary schools. We are just in the lovely, lovely, lovely village of Matthews. Anyone knows why I said lovely so many times? Because I live here. So if you want to stop up and have a bite to eat, I say no problem. I only have one room. I must have a babysitter. Anyone want to babysit my kids?
Yeah.
I only have two children, a boy and a girl. Now my daughter, she loves everything girly, while my son is in his Rambo phase. Now looking on the left here, one, but also called a lady of perpetual health. Pink because it is a lady. That for the first Catholic Church arrived here on the island, they had to suffer a lot of upsets. Because Antigua was once an Anglican dominant island, because the Anglicans, they built a church inside the city and then raised us up with dignity in 1702. And while the first Catholic Church, a priest by the name of Mr. A.J. Camacho, he wanted to get married. But then he had to get married within the Anglican Church. While the priesthood of the Guadalupe came here to the island, wanted to attend Mass, and found that there are no Catholic churches here on the island, and requested that one was to be built immediately. Other than the Anglicans and Catholics, we also have the Baptists, there are also the Methodists, we also have the Pentecosts, the Wesleyans, and I'm sure you are aware of the Jehovah's Witnesses.
Yes.
And we also have a Church of Scientology here, which is known as the Church of Science B. Now, I have not seen Tom Cruise here lately on the island, but maybe sooner or later, he will be coming to visit one of his parishes, and hopefully, he will not be jumping up on any couches. Stars are all over the place. Shumel Road. Alright, so this morning, folks, I'm going to show you how the process of sugar was done without the sugar factory. Because if you look here on the left hand side, we have the remains of our sugar mill. Originally built in 1900. Alright. But do you know that we had over 100 of these standing here on the island? But before the sugar cane became a great commodity here in England, we used to use these for cattle and also windmills. But eventually, after the sugar cane production was booming there, we had to do away with all of our cattle and windmills and strictly concentrated on sugar production. Now, the sugar production was done with the windmill blades being on the top, connected to a large steel hole in the middle, with a grinding stone at the bottom, which was used to grind out the juice of the sugar cane. They were then placed into a large cup bowl, which was over a water or coal fire. And when you boil it to the point where you start to see scum at the top scum was taken out to make molasses, which was actually used to make what, folks? Which is also my favorite word. And the bottom half was left to crystallize to make sugar. Now, the original color of sugar was dark brown. But over the years, of bleaching and adding chemicals to it has given us another color, which is white. But we say the original is always the best, and the doctor says so too. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, coming up on the left-hand side here, we're going to see another Anglican church. But this one is much more beautiful than the one which we saw inside of the city. Now, it's currently under restoration, folks, but this is the St. Barnabas Anglican Church. Built in 1824, damaged by an earthquake, and rebuilt in 1842. Now, did you know the stained glass on the church, folks?
Yes.
Those were the original glass the church was built with, but also the two different color bricks. The red bricks, which were the English bricks, they were used as ballast coming from the ships from England. Now, we never really needed them, but they still dumped them off here anyway. So all we simply did was trade them for rum and molasses. Now, over the years, folks, all the rum and molasses have gone, but we still have our English bricks. Now, the green bricks, which are the limestone bricks, coming from this area of the Burton. Limestone bricks, we knew that the island is volcanic. Yes, folks, we do have a volcano here on the island, but we do not know where it is located. Some person said we built a church on top of it, while other person said it is out to sea. But since we don't like trouble, we don't go looking for it. That's a great policy, right? Green bricks right here, the Grace Hill Moravian Church.
Grace Hill Moravian Church.
Yeah. Also here we have the Liberta Clinic. Now our clinics are funded by a tax which we pay, known as the Medical Benefit Scheme. We also pay Social Security, Education Levy, Property Tax, Value Added Tax, and a 15% tax known as ABST. Now ABST sounded like a luxury tax, because you do not put it on items which you cannot live without. Here on the Isle of Antigua, those persons who are 18 years or older are responsible for paying medical benefits, social security, and education levy. But while persons who import things, they pay value added tax, also ABST. And ABST is also put on items in the supermarket as well. While property tax is paid by those persons who have a piece of property. Regardless of if you have a house on it or not, you are still responsible for paying the property tax. Coming up on the right-hand side, folks, there is a cemetery. Tell me what you notice about it. Background. Anything else, folks? Didn't you notice that it was fenced around? Two reasons for that. To keep the animals out, and everyone is always dying to get in. But have you ever noticed that a cemetery is similar to a hotel, where everyone always checks in and no one ever checks out? So like Hotel California. Alright, but folks, have any of you ever seen Falmouth in England before? Or Falmouth in Massachusetts? Well, here on the right hand side, we have our own Falmouth. This is actually the Falmouth Harbor. And when the early British settlers came here to the island, they stood on top of the hill looking down and stated it reminded them of their Falmouth back home. Alright, so we're going to try and pull off down below so that we'll be able to take a beautiful picture of the Falmouth Harbor. Joseph. Got a nice shot there, folks. We have actually about 4 resorts on this side of the island here in the Eagle Shop and Falmouth area. And we also have others on the southern side of the island. Well, we have the Sandals chain and also the Jolly Beach Resort close to the ship. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, just to let you know that although the British settlers founded the Falmouth Harbor, it is now famous for an annual Sailing Regatta, which takes place in late April to early May. It is known as Antigua Sailing Week, where sailors from all over the world come to race for best ship, best captain, best crew. But do you know what they mostly come here for? The rum. Of course. Now here on the island of Antigua, we produce 3 different types of rum. We produce the Cavalier Gold Rum, which comes in at 80% and the 151 alcohol proof. There's also the English Harbor Rum, which comes in the 5-year-old, 10-year-old, and 1981 vintage. There's also the Skullduggery. Yes, folks, Skullduggery. Because an Australian gentleman came here to the island, he fell in love with the Cavalier Rum and said he wanted to make his own Cavalier. But unfortunately, the name was already taken. So he could not make his own Cavalier. So he saw a rum and said that actually looked like a skull. So why not I call my rum Skullduggery, make a skull, and put my rum in it. And that is how we got Skullduggery, folks. Alright, but for the 151 here on the island, you know, the 80% is just like a chaser, but the 151, you know, is jet fuel. So what we'll actually have to do, folks, is use the 151 on the holiday season. Because you know the St. Patrick's Day will be coming around very shortly. And of course, we have the Easter period. And you know, that would be a nice time for us ladies to do our cleaning. But also we have those neighbors coming over. You know, the ones that say, I like that. And then 2 weeks after you go to their house, and they have the same thing which you like in your house. But also, fellas, that good game will be on the television. And you know, the game-winning ball was just missed by an inch. And he wanted to let out that nice little curse word, but unfortunately the in-laws won't like it. So what you simply do is you serve that nice holiday drink with the 151, and in a matter of no time, you have a nice and peaceful and restful holiday. But if you think about getting rid of the in-laws, folks, that will not be the way to do it. Because I tried it the other day, and I'm still not able to get rid of my bloody in-laws either. This morning, ladies and gentlemen, do you know that the island of Antigua suffered a downturn economy in the year 2007, where parents found it hard to find necessary items for children to go to school, such as school meals and school uniforms? So the government decided they were going to provide these necessary items via a school uniform grant program, where you will carry your child's report card to the Ministry of Education or the child's birth certificate to ensure that the child is in school or will be going to school. While teachers were complaining that the kids were sleeping in class because not getting enough to eat or getting too much, so the government decided they were going to provide the school meals for these kids, where you could pay $2 US every day or $5 Eastern every day for your child to get in well and up to speed. Now, looking around this morning, everyone, you may see some beautiful garden flowers. And these are actually known as the bougainvilleas. The bougainvilleas are very popular here on the island. They're brought here by a gentleman called Mr. Louis Bougainville. here on the left-hand side, we're just passing an area which was once known as Rock Town. Rock Town because it was built along with houses. But when the sailors came off the ships in Southern Nelson's Dockyard, they used to come to this area to drink rum and also grow lemons. So shame on you boys for taking advantage of us. All ladies wanted the other way around. This morning, folks, is our tour is called Amazing Antigua. We'll be making three stops today. The first one will be at the Blockhouse. Then later to Shirley's High Lookout Point. Then afterwards in South of Nelson's Dockyard, where we will be misbehaving.
We're up at the Blockhouse on Antigua. And here's our Viking buses.